Next, Honorable Faiszer Mustapha, you have 25 minutes.
Honorable Deputy Chairman, I'm thankful that I'm being given an opportunity to speak a few words, the debate in the Constitutional Assembly. Firstly, I would like to quote a statement by Kumar Sangakkar. I will do that keeping paramount in mind my Sri Lankan identity. Play the game hard and fair and be a voice which Sri Lanka can speak proudly and positive to the world. My loyalty will be to the ordinary Sri Lankan fans, their 2 million hearts beating collectively as one to island rhythm, filled with an undying and ever loyal for this game. Fans of different races, castes, ethnicities and religions who together celebrate their diversity by uniting for a common national cause. They are my foundation, they are my family. I will play my cricket for them. Their spirit is the true spirit of cricket. With me are all people. I am a Tamil, I am a Sinhalese Muslim burgher. I am a Buddhist, I am a Hindu, a follower of Islam and Christianity. I am today and always proud to be a Sri Lankan. I'm happy that you said it's great. Like a member of Parliament, Rohini Kumari, pointed out, firstly, Sri Lankan politics, racism, ethnicity has become a stage. Unfortunately, to eradicate racism, hatred in this country, we have to do so within this house. This house is used to preach racism, hatred against one another. So firstly, for us to be united, members of parliament should think as Sri Lankans. I don't see that because today, even when we are debating on a new constitution, everything is about one's ethnicity, everything is about one's political goal. At the last presidential election, secularism was preached by one, racism was preached by another. The country defeated racism, and secularism was reborn. Mamme avasthavedi. Secularism, not a secular state, Mr. Honorable Member. If you don't hear me, you should hear me right. What I said was secularism. I didn't talk about secular state. Buddhism has to be given its foremost place. Sorry? Yeah, I will come to that. Just give me a minute. Deputy Chairman, may I be permitted to read this? Vivastava Vikurti Hadak Genayatai the Mama Piliganimi. Ebevin. Tavatavat, Palastar Ekatukirima Venuata, Janata, Patum, Pilimu Keran, and Nava Vivastak, Vasurak, Atula Samata Kirima, Avasha, Katayu to Karami Mahajana Niojitian Gen Saman with a Samasta Parliament to a Vivasta Sampa, the Mandalak, Bavata Patanu Atta Andukrama Visharadian, Vidvatunha, Burtivedin, Saman with a Purasi Podesa Sabavak, Patkarami. Vivasta, Ketumpata Pavatina Vivasta, Vidanavata Anukula, Samatakara Ganima Sandaha, Parliamentary Idripat Karami, Pavatina Vidayaka Janadi Patikrame, Mativana Krame, Niti and Adipatia, Yahapal Nati Shastra Siala, Nava Vivastavin Avarane Karami Vidayaka Janadi Patikrame, Vivasta, Sampadana Mande, Tirne Anuva Sudusu, Paradi Sansodane Karami. Samanupathika niyojanaya kottashakayama musukala nava mativarana kramayak handuna demi mahajana niyojitayan ayatana wala kaanta niyojana ihala nagwima sada avashya vivasthapita vidividana nava vivasthawakata ekkirimata yojana karami. This was all stated by President Mahinda Rajapaksa during the 2015 elections. This Honorable Deputy Chairman, this is not a point of order. My learned friend, I know he's trying to be a lawyer, but this doesn't fall within what when I'm reading a statement of when I'm reading a
that's
When I'm you honorable deputy chairman, you come to a finding whether it's just a point of order or not. I am reading something. How can when I read something?
Garu kehliya rambukwella mantituma.
Thank you.
Go ahead.
Now I am not a lawyer, but you are a lawyer. Thank you. Sri Lanka ve jathika prashne visnima sada ekiya ratak tula silu jathiyenge aithin tahawuru karana sadharana deshapalana visnumak laba deeme aramunen 13 wana aandukrama vyavasthave sansodhanayen obbata noyana palat sabha saha palat palana aayathana wada shaktimat karena deshapalana visnumak sandaha avatheerna wima ape aramunai. Mena this is the final manifesto. They are the final manifesto. You are talking of an obsolete one.
Honourable Minister, yes, you go on.
Honourable Deputy Chairman, Mr. President Mahinda Rajapaksa, in the 2015 election, Honourable Deputy Chairman,
yes.
President Mahinda Rajapaksa contested during the presidential election, making this pledge that he wanted a constitutional assembly. Right? That will create a constitutional assembly within a year. Right?
You would have done it by now.
And let me finish. Honorable Deputy Chairman, Honorable Member Kehliya Rambukwella states this was defeated. And then President Mahinda Rajapaksa took the stand that nothing beyond the 13th Amendment will be given at the parliamentary election. That is his stand. But I want to mention to this House, when President Mahinda Rajapaksa contested to be the executive president of the country, he pledged to the country that there is a need of a new constitution. There is a need for a constitutional assembly. And only as a presidential candidate, he asked the mandate from the whole country. When he contested Kurunagala to be an MP, that's a different story. Here, when President Mahinda Rajapaksa contested to be the president of this country, he very clearly stated that there should be a constitutional assembly. And President Maithripala Sirisena, this is what he said during the presidential elections, the new constitutional structure would be essentially an executive allied with the parliament through the cabinet instead of a present authority as executive presidential system. Under it, the president would be equal with all other citizens before the law. I guarantee that in the proposed constitutional amendment, I will not touch constitutional articles that would be changed only with the approval of a referendum. I also confirm that I will not undertake any amendment that is detrimental to the stability, security, sovereignty of this country. Therefore, both presidential candidates agreed on one thing, that the country needs a new constitution and that the constitutional assembly process should continue. Therefore, if any member of this House who has supported President Mahinda Rajapaksa or supported President Maithripala Sirisena states that they oppose this system, and also President Mahinda Rajapaksa cannot during the presidential election state that a new constitution is necessary, and at the parliamentary election says, I'm opposed to a new constitution. You cannot have dual standards in that manner. And also, this constitution has been amended 18 times. President Maithripala Sirisena is the only president. Every president who took office demonized the executive presidency, said that the executive president should go. President Chandrika Bandaranaike sat as the executive president, demonized the executive president, but took office and wanted to strengthen the executive presidency. President Mahinda Rajapaksa, I was a member of his government at that time, he stated he demonized the executive presidential during elections. What did he do? We all voted for the 18th Amendment as well, which further strengthened the presidential system. However, President Maithripala Sirisena is the only president of this country who agreed to devolve his powers. All of us voted for the 19th Amendment, including Honorable Kehliya Rambukwella, because the country thought the country thought fit, and he, President Maithripala Sirisena, agreed to give up his executive power for the betterment of the country, and he pruned his executive power. Therefore, we are dealing with a president who has given up his power for the betterment of this country, and all parties here believe that the 1978 constitution has to be amended or a new constitution has to be born. And how do we do that? We are a democratic country. The only mechanism to do that is through a constitutional assembly. However, I don't see any rationale. Some members of this house, is it a point of order? What's up?
Yes, Honorable.
Right?
I don't mislead the House.
Oh, just a minute. Listen first before you say it. I know you can't say before listening to what you're going to say.
You said
20th of January, 20th of January 2015, President Maithripala Sirisena made a solemn pledge that he will abolish or will the president. But in the SLAP proposals, they say the executive presidency must be there. That is the double standard.
Honorable Deputy Chairman, the Sri Lankan Freedom Party is now a democratic party. I don't think every leader of the party dictated his wish. However, we are a more democratic party. I can remember previously when I was a member of the Central Committee or when I used to go to cabinet, how leaders of this country make decisions. But President Maithripala Sirisena cannot take independent decisions even as the chairman of the Sri Lankan Freedom Party. He is dictated by the party. This party is dictated by the membership. This party is dictated by the Central Committee. The leadership cannot take decisions on his own. That's the difference, Honorable Keheriya Ramukwella. Mr. Honorable Keheriya Ramukwella, unfortunately, I was saddened by the statement of Honorable Keheriya Ramukwella when he said the Tamil people, the Muslim people, the Sinhalese of this country have equal rights in this country. How are we going to heal the wounds of the people in the north and the east? When Honorable Keheriya Ramukwella said, we can buy territory, I'm very happy that you have this view. At least you're giving me some credit, though. So Honorable Deputy Chairman, they say empty vessels make the biggest noise. So I'm happy that there are a few around here who are empty vessels, and I think I can enjoy a little background music, because I can remember when he was the defense spokesman, he did the similar task, right? You safeguarded me also, but thank you. Honorable Deputy Chairman, Sri Lanka ekiya rajyak viyutu bawa api sielu denama piliganna karunak namuth mehe ina samahara mantriwaru ekiya kiyana wacanaya ingrisi bhashawen pawichchi kirima gana prashnayak naganawa. Honorable Deputy Speaker, Deputy Chairman, I would like to read the Collins dictionary of the word unitary. These are members who have not Yes, I did. Just give me a minute.
Lokamaru enna single engar kiyan. Then what? Single engar kiyan.
Yeah, just a minute. Yeah, I have reading Collins. So I can state that. I'm just looking for it. Excuse me. Honorable Deputy Chairman, the word unitary and the word ekia. Just a. I'm just looking for it. I had it with me. Just give me a minute. You have it 1 minute. Just give me a minute. I will continue without it. Honorable Deputy Chairman, the word unitary means there is no distinction between that and the word ekia. Therefore, if one is to use that word unitary being used in English, one is playing politics to the gallery. As you know, the English singular version of our constitution prevails. Therefore, certain members are using every opportunity to discredit this process. The Sri Lankan Freedom Party stands for ekia Sri Lanka wakunu peni sitina bududahamata dena tanu wenuen api peni sitina e wage lankawe swairyabhavaya kisiseithma haanidayaka wana kisima waga sansodhana kiripat kirimata api viruddha wana bawa api sandahan kala tiyena yeah. Yeah. No, so is there an impediment in using the word ekia in English? Now, if as you being the great honorable Kelly Ramukwala, you be. Harshana, just look at the word choice in this. No, your argument does not hold water for this reason, right? For the reason that the word, you know what federalism is? Honorable Deputy Chairman Sharmananda J had defined what federalism is. According to Sharmananda J, Nitya Vashen Ekiya Rajyaka Swadipatya Balaya Nobedi Pavati Venat Akare Dakwane Madhyama Rajya Balatala Simakara Nata Ekiya Rajyaka Atyavashya Gunanga Dekakwane Madhyagata Parliamentu Uttritar Bhava Swadipatya Balaya Sahita Dvitva Apradana Ayatayak Namati Bhava. Also, where has defined what federalism is? Federal Kramiya Tula, Ekinagara Yatatnavana, Namadu Ohuta, Pavarun Labi, Vishapatya Tula, Samikshana Babaha, Swadinatya, Tavarwana Lesa, Federal Ha Raja, Anduatara Raja Palna, Visheshesta, Bedaharu Labia, Labai, Samakshiya, Saha, Ekinakin, Swadina Baladikarin, Pavat Pavati, Federal Muladarme, Hariyai. Federal Andu Krame, Samahara Karnu Pilibada, Swadipatya, Usulan Athara, Venat Katun Walter, Adala Raja Andu Swadipatya Balaya, Usulai, Ekinekata, Yatat Nove, Ekinek.
Order, please, Garu Katana, Ekatuma Mola, Senator.
Give me a minute, Honorable Faiszer. I have an announcement. Garu Mantriyuni Adhyayana Pawathi Parliamentu Katayutu Pimbada Karaka Sabhavedi Sakatcha Kala Thirnaya Paradi Anurakrama Vyavastha Mandale Milanga Rasvima 2017 November Masa 6 Wenna Dina Sandudana Nopawathwana Bawat E Wenuwata 2017 November Masa 8 Wenna Badada Purva Bhaga 10ta Sita Aparadha Bhaga 6 30 Dakwa Anurakrama Vyavastha Mandale Rasvima Partner Lamanabas, Chiru Mantriyo, Dhanasinu Kemetimi. Go ahead, please, Honorable Minister. Takutiladina.
Honorable Kehelia Ramukwala asked me a question. Is he had he left the house? About the word. Thank you, my learned friend. I saw you. The dictionary meaning of the word unitary.
Yeah.
since a lot of members have raised various issues with regard to the word AKA being used, the word unitary, according to the Oxford Dictionary, a single or uniform entity relating to a system of government organization in which the power constitutes parts are vested in a central body. Collins defines it as a unitary country or organization, which is one which two or more areas of groups have joined together, have the same aims, and are controlled by a single government. Unitary means that there are two or more constituent parts which the central body. One day, the vested powers in the central body may be sought to be shared by the constituent parts. We observe the situation which is considered as a unitary country. No, sorry? Honorable speaker, my honorable member,
yeah.
Honorable member has been disturbing me for some time.
But asked him for.
No, sometimes when empty vessels make the most amount of noise,
anyway,
it's quite entertaining,
your,
honorable
now, what
speaker.
What is your problem on me?
Honorable speaker is quite entertaining.
He mentioned my
4 minutes more. Why
yeah, he did mention my name, so yeah. I have the right to answer that.
No, what is
yeah. No, what he said was he was trying to explain what the unitary state is.
So, yeah,
unitary is a form of a government.
Yeah, sure, that's right.
So,
why don't you continue with your speech? You don't have to explain him, you continue to use.
Acharya Vyar Tama Nutana Andukrama Vyasta Krutya Dahanaman Pitwe Mema Suvisesha Venas Hua Dakpai. Federal Vyasta Sia Vishya Sima Tula Sama Rajaka Naitika Swadinatya Bada Novana Paridi Raja Bale Samasta Rateha Pradeshi Ekaka Raja Atra Bedaharan Lebe Rate Pashvika Rajani Payate Atat Novi Samas Ratasandahavu Raja Bala Adhikari යටතට ගෙන ශේෂ්ත්‍රය තුල ෆෙඩරල් රාජ්‍ය ක්‍රියාත්මක වේ අනෙක් අතට පළාත් රාජ්‍යක මධ්‍යගත රාජ්‍ය පාලනය නතු නොවේ තම බලය ක්‍රියාත්මක කරයි විශේෂයෙන්ම සමස්ත රට සඳහා වන ව්‍යවස්ථාවකට වගේම රාජ්‍ය හෝ පළාත් ව්‍යවස්ථා දාගේ ඇත්තේ සීමා කරනු ලැබුණු බලතලය කිසිවෙකුට යටත් නොවේ දෙපාර්ශ්වය සමීක්ෂීය වේ අනෙක් අතට ඒකීය රාජ ව්‍යවස්ථාවක තුල සමස්ත රට සඳහා වන ව්‍යවස්ථාදායක රට සඳහා වූ නීති සම්පාදන උත්තරීතර බලය සහිත ආයතන වේ එසේ අනෙකුත් ව්‍යවස්ථාදායක පැවති සහ බලය ක්‍රියාත්මක කිරීමට ඉඩ දිය හැකි නමුදු ඒ ආයතන යටතේ ස්වරූපය ගැනීම තුල ඒවායේ බල අතික්‍රමණය කිරීමට ඇති නෛතික අයද ක්‍රියාත්මක කළ හැකිය. Therefore, the president exercising the power through the governor was on the basis that the 13th Amendment it was declared that Sri Lanka is the 13th Amendment does not impinge upon federalism. The Sri Lankan Freedom Party has been very clear that we will not allow any provision which deals with federalism, also curtailing the powers of the governor. Curtailing the powers of the governor in any form with regard to the control which he has with regard to the provincial councils, the Sri Lankan Freedom Party has very clearly stated that it will oppose such provisions. However, Honorable Speaker, this House, there was diversity of views. The fundamental right of every citizen and the right of every member of his parliament to express his views has to be accepted. However, unfortunately, certain members of this parliament is using parts of this report to say that this government is trying to bring in a federal state and try to discredit the government by stating so. However, the very concept of a constitutional assembly is to give a ear to diverse views, debate it, and then reach consensus with regard to what we agree upon. Unfortunately, most members of this House seem to be interested in raising issues where there is differences. Only way, Honorable Speaker, this country can go forward if all of us together first agree on issues where we can create change. And I'm sure if all members of this party forget about their race, religion, or creed and act as Sri Lankans and think as Sri Lankans, we could all work together in bringing a new constitution or bringing new constitutional amendments with meeting. Therefore, Honorable Speaker, I thank that I am being given an opportunity to express a few words with regard to bringing a new constitution or amending the constitution. Thank you.